Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to be talking about surds. First definition. What are surds? Okay, so here they are. Surds are numbers that cannot be expressed in the form a over b, where a and b are integers. And of course, b cannot be zero, because if b is zero, that's going to make the fraction to be undefined. So what this tells us is that surds are numbers that cannot be expressed as a fraction. That's just it. That's the basic definition of surds. They are numbers that cannot be expressed as fractions, where the numerator and denominators of the fractions are integers. We also know that surds are irrational numbers. For example, the square root of 2 is a surd, because there is no way square root of 2 can be written as a fraction. Also, the root of 3 is a surd. The root of 5, the root of 7, and so on and so forth. Now, what do we think about these problems? Do we think the square root of 4 is a surd? Yeah, it's underneath a square root. So we see that the square root of 4 is also underneath the square root, just like these four expressions here. So square root of 4, do we think it's a surd or not? Of course it's not a surd. It's not a surd because the square root of 4 is a positive or negative 2, which, going by this definition here, can be written as a positive 2 over 1 or a negative 2 over 1. So we see here that the square root of 4 can be written as a over b. So the square root of 4 is not a surd. Similarly, the square root of 16. This can also be simplified as plus or minus 4. And this is going to be plus 4 over 1 or negative 4 over 1. Which is a way of representing this problem in the form a over b. So these are not surds. So whatever number that's underneath the square root that cannot be simplified and written in the form a over b is called a surd. So we are going to be focusing on the basic rules of surds. The basic rules of surds. There are a number of rules guiding the operations. So you want to take a, b as integers. So if a, b are integers, this rule is old. First, the square root of a over b is going to be equal to the square root of a divided by the square root of b. This is one rule of surd that holds. For example, let's assume that a is 9 and b is 4. Now, applying this rule, what this rule basically tells us is that the square root of a quotient is equal to the quotient of the individual surds. So here, if a is 9 and b is 4, we find that the left-hand side is going to be equal to the square root of 9 over 4. This is the square root of 2.25. And the square root of 2.25 is plus or minus 1.5. So this is the left-hand side. So the right-hand side, which is root a over root b, that's going to be root 9 over root 4. The square root of 9 is plus or minus 3. The square root of 4 is plus or minus 2. And 3 over 2, of course, is 1.5. So we can see, we can confirm the veracity of this rule. It holds. The square root of the quotient is equal to the quotient of the individual roots. So we can see that it holds here. So that's the first rule. The second rule says that the square root of a product is equal to the product of the individual roots. So let's use the same examples. Let's take the same values for A and B. So for example, if A is 9 and B is 4, so the left hand side is going to be 9 times 4. This is square root of 36. And this is positive or negative 6. And the right hand side, which is square root of A times the square root of B, is going to be square root of 9 times the square root of 4. This is 3 times 2, positive or negative, and this also gives a plus or minus 6. So clearly we can see that the left hand side is also equal to the right hand side. So this law holds. Now what do we think? Do we think we can extend these rules to plus or minus? Of course not. A plus B underneath the square root is not equal to the square root of A plus the square root of B. And similarly, the square root of A minus B is not equal to the square root of A minus the square root of B. Now, I'm going to ask you to confirm these two and perhaps drop whatever you find in the comment section. I hope you found this video useful. If you did, kindly like, subscribe, and share it. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video. Bye.